students. So we are going to start our online experiments. So our first experiment is volumetric analysis. So the aim is to prepare M/20 solution of Moomer salt, and Moomer salt is ferrous ammonium sulfate salt. That's ferrous ammonium sulfate salt. Formula is FeSO4.NH4 whole twice SO4.6H2. This is water of crystallization. Now, so this is Moomer salt. We are going to prepare the standard solution of Moomer salt at molarity 1/20. And using that solution, you have to identify the molarity and strength of KMnO4 solution, that's unknown solution. Just to weigh the salt, you have to apply the formula for molarity. Molarity you have taken for Moomer salt is 1/20. So molarity formula is moles of a solute for volume of solution, and that is taken in liters. Now you have to convert it into milliliter because you have to prepare the standard solution in 250 milliliter standard flask. So given mass, now moles of a solute has been opened up in given mass for molar mass, volume of a solution taken in milliliter, that's why the mole formula is being multiplied by 1000. So just apply the values now. So when we plug the values, 392 is a mass of molar mass of your Moomer salt. We plug all the values, we got a value as 4.9 gram. So we keep a watch glass over it, just to weigh our salt. We'll bring it up to zero, and then we'll weigh 4.9 gram of Moomer salt. And we will add 5 milliliter of a concentrated sulfuric acid into it. So here it is. So this is just to prevent the hydrolysis. And then we will start adding water. So first of all, you can wash the beaker which was carrying acid to the water, so that the remaining acid could be added to the salt. And then you can wash the petri dish to the water, and then you can start dissolving it. Because there is an acid, so it can be dissolved very easily. So you have to fill the water till this bulb of the titration flask get fully filled. And then stop there and then stir it nicely. So while mixing it up, see whether your cap should not be loosened. And you can see thoroughly mixed. And at the bottom, you can see there is no salt precipitate. That is what needs to be done. And then you have to bring the water level to the calibration, which is being shown here as a 250 milliliter calibration. Just below it, bring your water level, and with the help of a dropper, bring our solution nearer to the calibration. And please see that the lower meniscus should come and touch the calibration. The lower meniscus. Fine. This is right. So this is our unit. We have to first of all wash it with water, so that all the impurities could be removed. Rinse it well. And then let it pour off. This helps in removing the impurities, and then we can rinse it with the solution. Okay, this could be done 2 to 3 times. Then the KMnO4 solution which we have prepared, that we can pour in a burette, a slight amount, and then we can rinse it in the same manner as we have done with the water. So this will remove the water molecules
which we used for purification earlier. This could also be done 2 to 3 times. So we can fulfill the burette. First of all, see this level. Your burette should be closed. The stopper should be totally closed so that while pouring the
take care, the stoppers
tightly closed so that it will not pour out. Now the burette should be filled above zero level. So 50 milliliter burette, it should be filled above zero level. So that we can fill the nozzle afterwards.
So fill your burette with the KM-NO4 above the zero level. And then, and keep your eye view parallel to the zero level. That's the first condition when you fulfill your KM-NO4. And bring the upper meniscus to the zero level. Upper meniscus to the zero level. Perfect. Pipette. We have 10 milliliter pipette. We have to clean it in the same manner as we have done with burette. And we will clean it with the water first. And then you will clean it with the required solution. So fill the water first, clean it nicely. The hole of the walls should touch the pipette and then pour it out. So clean. After washing this, the Mohar salt solution which we have prepared, you have to pipette it. Slide them out. Just tilt it up. Take a slide amount of it. Then do it in the same manner so that the water molecule should be removed with the help of solution, your standard solution. You have to repeat the washing 2 to 3 times.
Fine, this is our 10 milliliter pipette and this is the calibration, and that is 10 milliliter calibration. So we have to bring our reaction, our solution just above this so that the lower meniscus should touch the calibration. Now we can pipette it out. Do it carefully because we have concentrated acid in this. So we have our solution just above the calibration level. So with the help of a air passage, by removing your index finger carefully, you can bring the level till the calibration point, just about to it. So that lower meniscus should touch it. Done. Perfect. Now, pour it in your flask. Pour it off into a conical flask and then hit it 2 to 3 times on the bottle so that the stuck to droplets will be released off. Now, you can add 10 milliliter of a dilute sulfuric acid into it. 10 milliliter of a dilute sulfuric acid, because our pipette was of 10 milliliter, that's why we are adding the equal amount. Okay, and carefully pour the KM-NO4 solution into it till it gets light pink coloration, that's permanent pink color. So this is a baby pink color. You have to bring this color exactly. That is permanent pink color and that's the color of a manganese ion. So the first reading, my first reading arrived at 10 and you can see the upper meniscus is touching the 10 value. Now I will repeat 2 to 3 times reading and whatever reading come, I will take the same reading. Whatever will be my same reading in 2 to 3 times reading, that should be considered my concordant reading. So our observation table now. Burette reading, I have taken 3 readings, the initial reading was all 0, final reading, 3 readings, out of that 2 were on 10, 1 was 9.5, so I got my concordant reading as 10 milliliter. So the volume of the KM-NO4 which has been used each time has been written here. So my concordant reading is 10 milliliter. So we have to apply the formula now, N1, N1, V1, that is N and M is actually the conversion of a normality. So
N2, N2, B2, and that's for respectively for KMnO4 as well as Mohr salt. You can see 5N1 is being written here. This is number of the electrons gained by KMnO4, that is permanganate ion, and 1, that is number of electrons lost by ferrous ion of the Mohr salt. So these are the number of electrons gained and lost being written here. So on resolving this formula, you'll get the value 1/100, that is 0.01 molarity. That molarity value you have to take here and find out the strength. So strength is molarity into molecular mass, so that is 1.58 grams per liter. Precautions, as you can read out, observe upper meniscus in the case of a colored solution. So our colored solution was KMnO4, observe the upper meniscus in that case. Lower meniscus in the case of a colorless solution, so our colorless solution was Mohr salt. So we have to observe the lower meniscus, and the lower meniscus is somewhere where the calibration is being captured by the low point of your solution. That is lower meniscus. And when you say upper meniscus, the calibration, if this is the calibration, your solutions, the upper meniscus, that means the points, that means the ultimate point should touch that solution. So this is upper meniscus. Clear? Next one. Motion rinse, pipette, and dure it 2 to 3 times, as you have already seen in the video. Third one, important. Pipetting should be done carefully because you have poured 5 milliliters of a concentrated sulfuric acid.